Ah, the city. Obey the law, and there's no need to worry about the residents. The city watch are the guys who want to lock me up, though. Gotta keep my eye out for them.
All right. Let's have a look.
So then I said, but I can't read. And so he says, they got the whole place under quarantine.
Oh, no. Same thing happened to me. I can read so I could see for myself. I asked why, but the city watch wouldn't give me the time of day.
What do you think? Some kind of plague?
That's what I thought. But then I was talking to Jesse down over the tavern, and he says that some kind of ship come into the docks. Something wrong with it. The quarantine is so that, and this is Jesse who said it, so take it for what it's worth, that otherwise the undead would be everywhere.
Everywhere? I wonder if Natalie is okay. She lives over in the docks near the Bloody Ears Tavern.
I know. And Grace O'Malley, too. Mind you, Jesse could be wrong.
Sure, he's been wrong before. That's right. Everything's probably all right.
Yeah, the city watch is just being careful. Doing this quarantine thing is a precautionary type step.
Yeah.
Alright, the key that I just nicked opens another house, which I will investigate soon. This is a fountain, the South Quarter Fountain, which is believed to be one of the places where the city was founded. So there are two water arrows. Those respawn every day. Before I'm not going to take them, I'm going to explain why I'm not going to take them. This is because they respawn every single day. And also, I already got the maximum amount of water arrows now, which is 25. So it would be wasted, because I tried to only take those elemental crystals once per game. Not once per day as I could, because it really is somewhat cheapening the game if you have the full and maximum amount of all those arrows at all times. Oops. Alright, here is a gas arrow. I think I'm actually taking it to show you what it is. It's a gas arrow which explodes in a burst of gas, which will knock out your opponents unconscious. Right. It's just a blackjacking effect on the distance. So, leaving the house again and moving on.
It's been a long day. Maybe tomorrow I'll get me some of that part-timey work down over at the factory. Hope they got some of those positions.
So here's a gate and we can't go through. Here's another little house which I'm not going to investigate just now. Bear with me. Just going and seeing the sights.
I trust all's well with you then.
So this house is opened with the key that I stole. However, if someone sees me entering this house by the front door, then they will get all jumpy and nervous and call the guards, but I wanted that key. It's like with the practice locks, I just have to have them all. So, here's a flash bomb and a healing potion. Both aren't of the respawning type. Same for the loot that I just stole. However, this here is a fire arrow, which is basically like a rocket launcher, yeah. It shoots a burst of fire. Can hurt undead, can hurt people, is noisy and loud. And a healing potion, so looted it. And leaving this house now. Let's save a bit of... Oh, the map. Yes, the map. This is South Quarter, as Garrett told us. Here's my my home, my house, my apartment, whatever. This is where Gerard lives, Mr. Wicked's house. Here's the door to Stone Market, which will be open as soon as we talk to Heartless Perry. Here's the fountain marked on the map. Here's a tree and a well. Here is the house that we have just looted. Here's a market stand, city watch, a prison, this Payflock prison, a gate to the docks, but the docks are barred off because of the quarantine, as those two guys told us. Black alley with the red hand fingerprint, and there's a fence and a shop. Let's have a closer look around. Here's the well. I'm trying something now. No, it doesn't work. It doesn't seem to work. No. I know that there is a place where it should work, but I'm not sure where. Maybe this way? Let's just leave it. You can mantle here on top somewhere and have a look at the end of the world, which is always a pleasure, isn't it? But pointless. Oh,
evening.
How is this?
Evening to you.
Here, that's the end of the world. Isn't this cute? You aren't really, oops, supposed to be here. yeah. Looking closer. Listen to this sound, please, and keep it in mind. The gate to the docks, which are closed shut. Here is a sewer grate with a something behind. Payflock prison, yeah. Cockroach type of creatures. And moving on to do business at the market shop. Market stand. By doing business, I mean taking their gold.
Those are City Watch. You can tell by their insignia. They're the guys I have to look out for.
Them are the City Watch. Right. Alright.
This is Black Alley. The red handprint is the mark of illegal establishments.
I'm now going to take the purse of Mr. Wicked, which is here. But first I'm going to explain something about purses in this game. And courier bags, I think, as well. As you just seen, this purse was worth 50 gold. There are other purses around, which we haven't encountered yet, but which are being carried around by peasants, like this guy here. And they are only worth 25 gold. So one item with two different values of worth. What happens now is that they share the same slot in your loot inventory, which I'm going to point out right now. Loot, purse of coins here. They will all be stacked onto the slot and they all acquire the value of the purse that initiated that stack here. If I had initiated that stack with the purse of some peasant at 25 gold, then all future purses would have been devalued into 25, even if they were of the 50 gold type. And it's working the other way around as well, which means that now that I have initiated that stack at 50 gold, every time I steal a small purse, it will increase in value. So, I'm going to visit Heartless Perry now, but first I'm going to point out and take a moss arrow. Moss arrows shoot moss onto the ground. This turns loud surfaces like metal plates into something really, really quiet. Or you can use it later on for a specific quest.